Are you guys ready for the upcoming iPhones? You better be. Right after intro. Hi guys and welcome to MD Channel. My name is Marco and this is your weekly fix of tech news, leaks, rumors and opinions. Everything about Apple and their competitors. If you are a fan of this type of content, please subscribe and don't forget to hit notification icon so you don't miss next video. One of the favorites in tech community, John Prosser from Front Page Tech, surprised everyone with leaks regarding upcoming iPhone 12 models. What I want to do is I want to summarize complete lineup of iPhones that Apple will be selling on their website till the end of 2020, possibly in the first or even second quarter of 2021. Without further delay, because it's gonna be juicy, let's get started. The total of 6 iPhones in 3 different segments. First is the low-end segment of the market. These 2 iPhones we already know. I'm talking about the iPhone SE, now already vintage design. 4.7-inch LCD display, 813 Bionic chip with neural engine, more than sufficient rear 12 megapixel rear shooter and 7 megapixel front facing camera, available in 64, 128 and 256 gig storage. This phone is for all those who want to give it a shot to an iPhone. High quality build, speed and responsiveness, although not so good battery life. But let's face it, this phone, it's not for those who want to play video games, shoot photos and videos and so on. This phone will be perfect for those who refuse to switch to Face ID and gesture-based navigation, since it's coming with Touch ID home button. Second device, also in the low-end segment, might be confusing, but I truly believe that Apple will continue selling iPhone XR until iPhone SE Plus is released. Although it's been with us since 2018, iPhone XR was the best-selling phone in 2019. And due to its powerful chip, A12 Bionic, it's still more than capable and even tempting as 2020 device. You can get it in 64 and 128 gigabytes configurations with second generation Face ID, 6.1-inch liquid retina display, 12 megapixel rear camera, 7 megapixel front facing shooter, and really, really good battery life with potential price drop to $499, for example. It could still be a killer phone. XR is still value for the money. A multimedia power horse, although with year or 2 years less of Apple OS support. This year, iPhones of the mid-range segment are coming in pair. iPhone 12 and iPhone 12 Max. One is an all-new form factor, 5.0-inch OLED Super Retina display with 4 gigs of RAM, available in 128 and 256 gigabytes storage configurations, and bigger with 6.1-inch display, also OLED, and similar internals. Both models, like those from previous segment, are made out of aluminum. iPhone 12 and iPhone 12 Max will be powered by Apple's latest A14 silicon. It's expected that this year's models will come once again with dual camera setup, wide and ultra-wide, similar to iPhone 11, and probably with some extras. Both of these devices are expected to have equal or even better battery life than previous generations, enough to be highly capable all-around phones. What's new here are OLED screens by Boe, technology group from China. While it may give the impression that this is less known company, not only that Apple and Samsung will be using their displays in the future, but we have already seen models on the market with screens produced by the same manufacturer, like foldable Motorola Razr, Huawei Mate 10, Huawei P40, etc. Starting price $649 for smaller model and 6.1-inch version for $749. Finally, the last group are from high-end segment. iPhone 12 Pro and iPhone 12 Pro Max. Both of these flagships are coming with Samsung's OLED XDR Super Retina display, ProMotion technology, and 10-bit color depth, which comparable to 8-bit and 16.7 million colors range, can show over billion colors. powered by Apple's A14 Bionic. High-end iPhone 12 lineup will be equipped with 6GB of RAM, which is welcome news. We are still not certain about camera details, but what we know for sure is gonna be again triple lens camera setup, wide, ultra wide, and telephoto, with possible 3x optical zoom. Some reports suggest that iPhone 12 Pro and iPhone 12 Pro Max will be using 64 megapixel sensor. For those interested in AR, this year's stainless steel models are coming with lighter sensor, similar to one in recently released iPad Pro. Apple will sell these models in three configurations: 128GB, 256GB, and 512GB of storage. 6.1-inch iPhone 12 Pro will start from $999, while iPhone 12 Pro Max will start from $1099. We don't have any information about battery capacities of whole iPhone 12 lineup, but we can expect improvements in higher efficiency thanks to Apple's 5nm A14 chip. So, are you guys ready to buy new iPhones, make the switch, or make the upgrade? Please share with me in comments below. Which one would you pick? If you like this video, hit the thumbs up, and if you can share this with someone, it would be awesome. I would be really thankful. Thank you for watching. Have an excellent day. Bye.